Hello folks, this is Jamil Sweat for GovSnark Reviews. We're here in my secret bunker location in Peoria, Arizona. And today we have a Mossberg Shockwave. This is a 12-gauge version with a 14-inch barrel. This is a great little firearm and is really effective and is really, really, really well priced. And we've done some modifications. We added a Picatinny rail on top, and we added the TACCOM grip tape on the grip. But you know what? A lot of people kept saying that they like the Magpul forend for it. And this one happens to have the TACCOM strap and the TACCOM grip tape on it, which you can see videos of how to install those here in GunStock Review, so check them out. But today, we ordered this one for the Mossberg. And we thought, oh, it goes from the 500, 590, 590A1 with different attachments. You have to put these attachments in front. And then we figured out the hard way that it doesn't fit the Shockwave. But what do? I've seen a couple of YouTube videos out there in which people say, take a Dremel tool or a knife or any other source of sharp instrument and start cutting into the back end or the front end or all sorts of parts to make it fit. Well, first things I'm going to tell you, you cannot or should not give me anything sharp. I have 7 stitches on this finger to prove that if you give me anything sharp, I am going to cut myself and end up in the hospital. Not a good idea. So I went ahead and called the guys at VanComp up in Chino Valley, and I told them, look, here's what I got. And they said, no problem, bring it up, we'll make it fit. So they have a fixture in their mill in which they do the modifications for you, and you don't have to do anything else just but install it. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna go install this modified Mossberg forend for the Mossberg shotgun. This is made by Magpul again with all the TACCOM modifications, and we're gonna put it on the Mossberg Shockwave. So first things first, make sure the gun is empty. Firearm. Another cool thing we did to this firearm, we put this spacer in here that actually allows you to use the little mini shells. So you have more capacity and much less recoil, either slugs or buckshot, mini shells rock. So let's go ahead and take this apart. We're going to take the cap off and remove the barrel. Okay, barrel out. We're going to use the supply tool that that Magpul sends, and we're going to remove the forend, the factory Mossberg forend. And there's a castle nut in there that holds the forend in place. It takes a little bit to unscrew it, so you have to be patient with it. Okay, out. Make sure you don't lose that. And remove the Mossberg part. Don't lose it in case you want to use it again. And then you install your Magpul part on it. The big difference is that now you have enough threads showing in here after the modifications so you can actually put your castle nut back in place. Let's go ahead and do that. And the cool thing is, with the modifications from VanComp, you don't need the little spacers to be back in there again. So nice and snug, but not over tighten. Never over tighten anything like a screw or anything like that, because you don't want it to come loose. No, while you fire it, but you also don't want it to be all over the place and, you know, and damage your part in case you need to take it off again. You don't need to send it back to the factory to have them remove it because you broke your tool. So now we put the barrel back in it again and we're ready to go. And you have to pull the forend a little bit out so the barrel will fit back in. And put your cap back on. There you have it. With the TACCOM strap, you're gonna, and it's a great addition to keep your hand from going forward of the muzzle while you're firing it, and you end up sending your hand down range a couple of, you know, 100 feet in little itty bitty pieces. It's not pretty. So let's go ahead and take it to the range and shoot it as is with the mini shells. I wanna see how the mini shells pattern compared to the full size shells. Why don't we go ahead and do that? So stay tuned for more so we can do that test. And like I say, always say, be safe and have fun at the range.
Thank you for watching Gunstock Reviews. Please visit our website at www.gunstockreviews.com for more exclusive content. Please visit our patron page at www.patreon.com/gunstockreviews. Your contributions would be greatly appreciated and help us grow our selections and frequency of videos.